Dermot Kennedy is a one-way ride to paradise. There's a thousand miles between you and I. Oh, my. With soulful lyrics and a stunning voice, his songs set the scene for any modern romance. You got that power over me. Despite amassing more than 7 billion streams and playing some of the world's biggest and tiniest stages, he's never strayed far from his roots. Oh, you loved me more than anyone. Yeah, we were up so high. Now, lucky for us, he's made it back to Oz to bring us his latest tour. So kiss me the way that you would
if we died tonight. Sounds like quite a kiss. Please welcome Dermot Kennedy! Hey Dermot, I want to say welcome but also congratulations for being here because you're hot off the Arias. I was going to say fresh, that doesn't seem like the right word.
How's the hangover? No, I'm doing all right. Yeah, we were there last night, it was brilliant.
Yeah, are you sober? I'm just going to be blunt.
Yeah, I'm good, yeah. I learned about the word dusty today for the first time, so I don't feel too dusty.
Excellent. Hey, you played some very unusual locations as part of your tour just this year. What's the strangest?
I think there was one recently where we had to hike for about 8 or 9 hours to get to the very top of this mountain in Switzerland and just played in a cabin to about 50, 60 people. It's for a very close friend of mine, and I will never, ever do it again, yeah.
Mate, it seems like everywhere you go, you end up busking. Have you had a chance to hit the streets here in Australia?
Not just yet, no. I know it's an important part of the culture, though, so I would love to do that, yeah.
What's better, like a packed street or like a main stage at Glastonbury?
What do you think?
I reckon a busy street, maybe?
yeah. No, it's funny, you know, like it's quite simple. If you're playing to 50,000 people, if you're playing to 100 people, genuinely, it doesn't change too much for me. It feels like a similar thing. So, yeah.
I was thinking about busking today. It must be getting hard now that no one takes cash anymore. Do you have one of the tap things, like a payway?
People do. People literally do.
Really?
Yeah. Because when I was doing it, it was all cash, obviously, and you'd sell CDs and stuff. I'm not sure how people do it today, but yeah, it's got to be trickier than when I did it.
Hey, Dermot, the fans at your shows, they seem to weep at some of your songs. How does it feel looking out and seeing people crying at your music? Does that ever get a bit awkward?
No, genuinely, it puts me in my place. You know, like, we tour so much, we play these songs so many times, and you can never let it kind of... It can never be numb the way you do these things. And so when I see somebody feeling the song as much as I should be, it checks me a bit and puts me in my place.
So if the whole crowd is emotionally bereft and bawling their eyes out at the end of the gig, is that considered a massive success?
Definitely, yeah. I think you often see people experiencing these emotions that... I think live shows, music, it can put you in a place where you just... It's this window of time where you can be so vulnerable and so emotional, and I think I'm very happy to be kind of doing that for people.
So what about busking? Is it the same busking? Do you like... You're out on the street, people walking by, dropping money in a thing and just bawling their eyes
just
out?
In tears. Yeah. No, yeah, you get... Sometimes, but busking's a funny one, yeah. It's a tricky thing. To be honest, I'm glad I'm not doing that anymore.
Oh, hang on, no, because a minute ago you said whether it's 50 people or 100,000 people, it's all the same.
I'm
and now you're like, I'm so glad I never have to do that again.
Yeah.
Dermot, Fred again is one of the biggest DJs in the world right now, and he actually sampled your song, and it was huge. We might take a little listen. Now, that's a very different sound to your songs regularly. So what's it like hearing your song changed into a banger?
That's the thing, though, right? It's so different, but it still carries so much emotion. I think that's why people kind of connect with him so much. It's because it has... It's that elation, but also it's such emotional music. I remember, like, he just kind of... That audio of me singing that song is from me playing in the street in Paris years ago. And he just kind of texted me and asked if he could use it. And I said, yeah. And then it becomes this kind of huge thing. So, yeah, I'm delighted.
But songwriters, they have a special bond with their songs. I've heard some refer to them as, like, their children, all this sort of thing. What's it like seeing your child become something so radically different? Is it like, what are you doing to my baby? Is it like, I can't believe he's grown up? Like,
yeah.
What's that relationship like?
It's beautiful. I mean, like... it's so cool to me that I can write this acoustic song and then he can have this vision and it can just be a totally different thing, I think. But it can carry the same sort of emotion. I love that.
I love it. You're saying the song's just so good, it doesn't matter what you do with it. I get it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey, you on social media are always answering questions from fans. And I think you basically admitted that you answer the easy ones, right? Because you don't want to have to answer some of the other ones you get. I don't want to know about the easy ones, mate. I want to know about the freaky ones behind the scenes. What's your favourite question that you've decided not to answer?
Oh, yeah, you should see the ones I skip over. But there's certain ones, yeah, at the wrong time, one of them can throw you for a loop. If someone's kind of like, how has a career in music, like, affected all your relationships? And you're just kind of like, oh, God.
We have a question from a viewer. Yeah. How has your career in music affected all your relationships?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You don't have to answer that. You can catch Dermot on tour and his limited edition vinyl with bonus tracks is out tomorrow. All the info is on our website. Dermot, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.